Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, go ahead and click that subscribe button to get more art and, I'll be honest, pretty random and miscellaneous project content. In typical Pacific Northwest fashion, the weather decided to take a 180 turn on us, and we went from having boiling hot weather that killed all of my grass to cool weather and cloudy skies. Now, in the interests of full disclosure, I do feel the need to tell you guys that my idea of quote-unquote cool weather is about 70 degrees. What can I say? I'm a delicate hothouse flower. I actually take a lot of joy from the times when the weather turns, though, to be honest. It gives me an opportunity to embrace the spirit of coziness, which comes pretty naturally for me. And having a hot cup of tea is one of the biggest steps. I share my love of tea with my mom and my sister, and it always brings me so much peace to be able to practice the ritual of making tea, of boiling the water and letting it steep and adding the honey. And on days when I'm feeling particularly smart, maybe even letting the water cool enough that I don't burn my mouth. The sketchbook that I'm using here is quickly becoming one of my all-time favorites. It has this super cute, helpful little bookmark, nice heavyweight paper that handles paint well, this helpful pocket at the back that I use for storing some saran wrap, and although you can't see it here, the paper is highly textured so it grabs the paint. If you've tried to paint on a smooth surface before, you understand what I'm saying. For anyone that is not new to seeing my art style, I am very messy. So the first step is to go ahead and wrap the rest of the book with this plastic so that when my paint goes everywhere, I'm not ruining additional pages in the book. My first sketch is done with this Papermate pink erasable lead click pencil. I really adore the pink specifically, because even though I have a very heavy hand, this erases clean and easily, and I don't leave indents or markings on my paper that I don't plan to. And I'll go ahead and leave the link in the description box just in case anyone's curious. I ran into the classic artist problem while I was working on this drawing, which is that I had already finished the perfect sketch that I was completely in love with. Seen in the top left corner of this video, and then as soon as I reached the end, I brushed my hand across the page and smudged it really bad. The reason that's a problem is because it meant that while I was using that prior sketch as a reference, I was also comparing my current sketch to the original the entire time, and it was kind of hard not to find the new sketch wanting. I think a lot of the reason that this happens is as a natural repercussion of the art process. We always say, trust the process while we're in the middle of making a piece of art. And the reason we say that is because an incomplete piece is never going to look as nice as a partial drawing. I tried to keep these thoughts in my head while I was going through the process. But to be honest, I still ended up spending a lot of time going back and forth, erasing and redrawing lines on this. Still, despite the challenges, I eventually reached a point where I was happy with how Twig looked, which meant that I got to start filling in the general idea of his surroundings. To my surprise, I discovered that drawing cartoon landscapes is a lot of fun for me. I don't know, there's just something about the whimsy and the simplicity. I guess they remind me of my childhood, and it just brings me joy. Who would have thought? And now for the part that's really gonna bring this to life. When I start setting down the paint, it always feels like a real make it or break it moment. I mean, it's true that acrylics are pretty flexible and forgiving, which is part of why I enjoy and use them so much. But once I start adding paint to a page, it can never be a drawing. It can never be a sketch again. I am committed. But on the other hand, I love the way that the touches of color instantly bring life to the page. It's like I'm watching the ideas in my head come to life right before my eyes. It's incredible. And especially in the case of this drawing, because this is one that I've been working on for a shockingly long time. Believe it or not, the drawing I'm painting over now is actually the fifth sketch I've done for this idea. The very first abstract idea for this painting actually came to me shortly after I finished watching the Hilda episode, The Deer Fox. For anyone that hasn't seen it, I don't want to give anything away. But basically, I care for my pets very dearly, so this episode definitely struck a chord with me. It was one that left me with a lot of feelings, good feelings, but still really filled my head in a way I felt like I needed to express. And that's where the very first sketch came in. To start, I had a pretty basic idea of what I wanted. I knew I wanted twig, I knew I wanted the northern lights, and I knew I wanted grass. But as anyone who's drawn even a stick figure in a background can attest, that much information still leaves a surprising amount of variation available. So I dug down, figured out more of what I wanted the piece to look like, and made the second sketch. And this one was particularly difficult because I couldn't find any references that had Twig, the deer fox, in this exact pose. Which meant I kinda had to fudge it and figure it out on my own. And this is most obvious in the placement of his ears. But eventually, I found a pose I was happy with, and I was ready to make what I thought would be the final sketch. And then the smudging happened. At first, I debated ways that I could change or fix the smudge drawing. I thought about trying to color over it, or maybe even just painting over that sketch. But ultimately, I had to accept that the book I had done the sketch in was not painting paper, it was for sketching only, and adding water to the pages would have made them warp and ruined the drawing even further. So instead, I buckled down and made the fifth drawing, which at this point was mostly just practice for my hand. And as you can see, I only ended up getting through the very first sketch phase before I realized this wasn't what I really wanted because I wanted it to be a painting. But as it turned out, smudging that fourth sketch ended up being a blessing in disguise. And smudging what I thought was my perfect drawing forced me to put in the extra work and to really finish the painting as it should be. And was it a journey, let me tell you. My dedicated guinea pigs, I mean beta art testers, received way too many in-progress photos of this painting before it was done. In particular, the color of the grass was something that I struggled with because it needed to have the right feeling. It needed to fit the magic of the scene without being eye-grabbing or taking too much of the attention away from Twig the deer fox. So my poor friends and family suffered through many, many iterations and very kindly continued to give me their advice, thoughts, and encouragement so that I could get through the process and finish with a piece that I am so incredibly proud of. I'm just so glad that I didn't give up. And I guess in the end, this is a story of how a little bit of perseverance and, well, to be honest, my very stubborn nature can turn something that could have just been a failure into a growth opportunity, as corny as that sounds. 'Cause hey, I figure you're gonna take a loss every now and again no matter what you do, so you might as well at least learn something from it.